And estates whatsoever, including any property over which I have a general power of appointment by will, to my trustees upon trust, to my two beloved sons, Kurt Ludwig Gutenberg and Gustav Otto Gutenberg, in equal shares absolutely, provided that either of them shall predecease me leaving a child. None of this last bit is relevant. Of course, alive, and there are no grandchildren. Yet. So, couldn't be more straightforward. Everything split right down the middle. Just as well all wills aren't as simple as this, or I'd be out of a job. Oh, and there was this. Your father sent this to me just over a year ago, soon after he fell ill.
What is it?
I have no idea. It's addressed to both of you.
Thank you.
I'm always here if you need me.
Thank you so much.
My darling boys, by the time you are reading this, I will be gone. But I wanted you to know that you have both given me so much joy in my life. Not just watching you grow as individuals, but in the knowledge that you both have so much affection for each other. I think brotherly love is a truly wonderful thing. Do you remember when you were both little, having to sit together in front of the fire on rainy evenings, and I would tell you stories? And when I had finished, you used to say, "Papa, just one more." Well, I have one final story for you both. So why don't you pour yourself in beer? I think you are going to need it. It all began in 1939 on a dairy farm in England. The farm was owned by Jacob Jackson and his wife Margaret. They had two sons, Jake and Greg.
Hey there. Just you wait till your father hears about this.
That's enough, Jacob.
Not so rough, Jake. You should learn to treat the lady properly.
I said that's enough. I'll have that, thank you. So where'd the bike come from, eh?
Borrowed it. For me.
500. Vertical twin.
Very sweet. Triumph Tiger.
What mates might that be, eh? He says he borrowed it, Jacob.
Just for the day. It's Charlie Powers. Giving it back tomorrow.
You're working here tomorrow, that's what you're doing. There's more than enough work to be done without you messing about with motorbikes that don't belong to you.
We're fixing the fortune tomorrow.
Magneto's not Spartan.
Not many two of us can't put right away, Dad.
I'm fine, thank you, Mrs. Jackson.
Come on, Sally. Eat up. Ain't nothing out of you.
Don't say that. Get rid of it, Jake.
We can eat it.
Get rid of it.
I know how to skin it. Dad showed me.
We'll see what your father has to say, shall we?
Did
Just a kitten.
He took your gun.
Not enough meat on it to feed a sparrow, let alone a family of four. Sorry, old boy. Don't like it.
He took your gun.
Stop it, Jake. Fred and me died a year back.
So?
So I need time.
I don't do time. I do now. You never loved him.
I did so. Anyway, you know nothing about love, do you?
Love you?
You just want me.
That's the same thing, isn't it? What do you want? Well, go on. Have a look. He's not interested in your tit salad. He's a homo.
You're not a homo, are you, Greg?
Right now. Come on.
No phone today. Being a bit tricky.
Hey! Back was all choked up. Coming? A couple of quick jobs to do and I'll meet you up the top field.
Thank you.
I don't believe what you said about me. I know you like girls. Keep me looking at me. They say there's going to be a war. What do you do if there's a war?
There might not be.
Of course there will. Everyone says it's going to happen. What do you do? You go and fight. They might call. That's what they do, ain't it? Come get you. Make you sign up and all. If you go to war, you have to kill people. I don't think I could ever kill anyone, could you? There might not be a war. What were you reading just now?
Nothing.
You weren't nothing. I saw you reading. I might read.
Sorry. You all right? Here, let me. Hold still. There.
Helping Dad.
Why'd you cut your thumb?
In the starting end of the fortune. It's running perfectly again now, though. Dad's up in the top field, Dad. Come give him a hand.
You do that.
I will.
Jake? No matter. Shakespeare's sonnet.
The villain.
We know what a sonnet is. Shakespeare. He's good, he is.
He wrote plays as well.
Greg, I ain't stupid. We used to have to learn poems in school. I like poetry. I was good at it. Not like songs and stuff. I never read up to save my life. But poetry makes everything ocean round Earth's human shores, or gazing on the moon's soft fallen mask of snow upon the mountains and the moors. No, yet still steadfast, still unchangeable, pillowed upon my fair love's ripening breast, to feel forever its soft fall and swell, awake forever in a sweet unrest. Still, still to hear her tender taken breath and so live ever, or else swoon to death.
Where did you get it?
Borrowed it from me.
No, you didn't.
Oh, it's the peacemaker.
Don't point that thing at me.
Ain't loaded.
I don't care if it's loaded or not. Don't point it at me.
What are you doing, my girl?
I'm not your girl. You don't know me.
Yes, I do. It's yours, it's mine.
Come here, Jake.
Do it, have you?
See, wouldn't have killed me. I reckon you have to still be the same. You don't change, do they? There are many times you do it. I was going to be one in six.
No one's leaving the farm.
You miss him. If he had to go to your left. Greg, you miss him, won't you?
The boys are farmers. It'll be a reserved occupation. No one's going anywhere.
Against Abel his brother, and slew him. And the Lord said unto Cain, Where is Abel thy brother? And he said, I know not. Am I my brother's keeper? And he said, What hast thou? I have that, thank you. In your pocket. What's in your pocket, Gregory?
Nothing.
Stand up. Empty your pockets.
Please.
Now. To the front. Now. Hold out your hand.
No one for you, Frank?
No, not for me, but work to do.
Work? This time of night?
We stay on for a few more, then.
Well, me, Friday night, I'll be here for a while. I'll be soon, then. I'll have another one. Who else is having one? It's in the bar, should I? Front drinks all round.
Come on, save some.
Responsibilities here. This is a farm. We've got a country to feed. They're dependent on us.
You'll be fine, Mother.
What do you know about fine? There are plenty of young men who can go off and fight. Who's going to farm the land, eh? Who's going to feed everyone here?
I'm sorry. I can't stay here. Not now. I have to go. For Jake.
For Jake? For Jake? He's a cripple, Greg. Worthless. You'll hate every minute of it. even kill a flea. Go. Oh. If you let him go.
He's not a child no more. He can make up his own mind.
No, he can't. You let my son go to war.
Our son.
Greg's mine. You had nothing to do with him. Jake's yours. Hell, Jake.
Best our country can muster, in its hour of crisis, go help the regiment and go help the country. And what have we got here? An horrible little Nancy boy. Let me make one thing abundantly clear. The only thing you'll be sticking up another man's arsehole is the bayonet attached to your Lee Enfield rifle. And the only recipient of such dubious pleasure will be Jerry. And he's not Jerry, are you?
No, sir.
And he's not Jerry either, are you?
No, sir.
No, sir, no, sir. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, sir.
Loud and clear!
Yes, sir.
Then stand up straight like a soldier, not a fucking Nancy boy.
I'm not a Nancy boy, sir.
Are you contradicting me, laddie?
No, sir.
What are you, then?
A Nancy boy, sir.
Louder!
A Nancy boy, sir.
I want to hear what you are. Louder!
A Nancy boy, sir.
Not in my fucking army, you're not. If I so much as see you! Looking in the direction of another man's arsehole. I'll personally ensure you wish you hadn't been born. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, sir.
Do I make myself clear?
Yes, sir.
You lot, stop bloody smirking and move your arses, or Mr. Nancy boy here will be poking something up there. Next two. On guard. On guard. No! Next two. On guard. On guard. Next hope! Oh God! Oh God! Next hope! Oh God!
Oh God! Highlander. Comes he here? We will take prisoners.
My breath now.
My mold is left here. You're soft in the bleeding edge, you are.
Come on. Get your stuff together. We need to make a move. What the war ags say.
This is a dairy farm, Frank. I ain't never grown no flax before.
Now use the seeds for linseed oil. Good for waterproofing and treating timber. It's all part of the war effort, as they say.
What about you, then? You going to be growing the stuff and all?
Don't you worry about me. I'm already doing my bit for king and country.
What if I says no, eh? What if I says they can stick their flax? What are these war ags going to do then, eh?
They got powers, they have.
Oh, yeah? And how come you know so much about it? How come you know so much about these war rags? You're one of them. And you, Frank. Not content with running your own farm, you have to go sticking your nose into other people's affairs.
Like I said, Jacob, I'm just doing my bit for England. Look, I don't want to make things difficult between us. I've always been very fond of you and Margaret. I'm just in the middle of a great big chain, that's all. It gives me my orders. I just pass them on.
Oh, no. It's just this bloody war. Not with Jake as he is now, and Greg gone.
Yeah, Margaret was beside herself. I spoke to Greg. I told him he didn't have to go. His mind was made up.
You told him that, did you?
Well, I knew just how much it would break Maggie's heart to have him gone.
Did you know? It was him, wasn't it? Frank. It was him.
It was a long time ago, Jacob.
Oh, I can do the adding up, Maggie. I can work out exactly how long ago it was.
Well, for you, English soldier, eat. I am a miller. I make the flour, all my own work. Well, not quite. My daughter, she bakes the bread. Christabel. This is not a good place for you. Germans are everywhere, like rats, vermin.
It's good. Thank you.
Ce sont des Anglais. De braves hommes. Ils nous aident contre les Allemands. She's very, timid.
Thanks, sweetheart.
We thought the French had all surrendered.
We're still bleeding from the last war. And the wounds are deep. But we do what we can. Some of us, anyway. We do our bit. But you must go when you've finished. If you head due north, you'll get to the coast. It's only about 20 kilometers from here.
And then? When we get there?
You have more chance of survival than you've got here.
And you?
I can take care of us.
Wacken auf den Boden!
Sehr gut.
Das Schwarzproblem, mein Lieber.
Nicht für euch.
Aber wir sind doch Ihre Gäste.
Hä?
Prost.
Ihr seid nicht eingeladen.
Wir wollen euch nichts Böses.
can hier bleiben. Also, gewöhnen Sie sich lieber daran, ja? Sie was gefragt, Monsieur. Ist das die Ihre süße Tochter?
Wie alt?
Wie alt ist Ihre Tochter?
18.
18.
Hey, wenn du fertig bist, bin ich dran.
Lass sie in Ruhe, Klaus. Sie ist zu jung.
Was will sie doch?
Wir sind hier in einer Kirche. Das ist ein Ort Gottes. Lass sie in Frieden.
Halt's Maul, Egon. Das ist eine kleine Franzosenhure. Du kommst auch gleich rein.
Sie ist eine Jungfrau.
Ja, du anscheinend ja auch.
Bastard! Verzeihung! Verzeihung! Ihr seid in Frankreich willkommen. Oh, bitte. Lass meine Tochter in Ruhe. Sie ist alles, was ich habe. Hier, trink. Bitte schön.
Also jetzt sind wir Freunde, ja? Mein Vater will, dass wir Freunde werden. Also, mach die Beine breit.
Ja, zeig ein richtiges deutsches Stück.
Nu! Mach die Beine breit.
Lissler! Bastard!
Mach die Beine breit!
Mach die Beine breit!
Breiter! 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 Verdammte Schlampe!
Was habe ich getan?
Points to use your journal, love. Please. Just having a pint with my son, Frank. If that's all right with you. You don't have to stay if you don't want to. Not if you've got work to be doing. Like fucking my wife.
Thank you.
is, it doesn't matter. You must have a point in it.
Is it just you and...
You're right. You're right. I haven't got the bars. But you have. You have. You're mad. Why did I want to kill myself?
Yourself, son. Flax. They want us to grow flax. What the fuck do they know? Fucking warlocks. What do they know about flax?
We don't need them, do we, Sam? We'll be on this fucking farm on our own, eh? Just the two of us. You and me, eh?
How long have you been here at the meal?
Just over a week.
9 days, to be exact. Tu apprends très vite.
C'est un homme bien. Il prend soin de moi.
Oui, je sais. Burn your uniform, Gregory.
Thank you.
We bring in a new fortune tomorrow. Apparently this new world is a slight easier start than the old one. Never did like those Jimmy Mornings. Neither do I. For that matter. Flax is doing nicely, up in the top field. I thought you might like to know. You'll tell me if you need anything, won't you, Mickey? Right then, I'd best be off. Well, see you tomorrow morning. I'll be on.
Le pain masculin, la pomme féminin.
Comment c'est?
Oh, vous êtes censé dire caisse?
La caisse? La caisse.
C'est une bûche.
Une bûche. Caisse?
Un feu.
Un feu.
Les flammes.
Les flammes. Qu'est-ce?
Votre cœur.
Votre cœur.
Votre cœur. Mon cœur.
Votre cœur. Mon cœur.
Oui, vous êtes un très bon élève.
Élève?
Élève. Étudiant. Pupille.
Ah, pupille. Yes, the same in English. Pupille. Qu'est-ce?
La bouche.
La bouche. La bouche, la bouche.
La bouche, c'est féminin. Féminin pour toi et féminin pour moi.
Thank you.
bell. Is there something I can hear?
Je préférerais avoir un petit garçon, une petite fille.
Une petite fille. J'aimerais avoir une petite fille.
Here, let me help. Looks like you twisted your handlebars.
What about me?
Ain't nothing wrong with your handlebars, sweetheart. Here. Hey, look. Your leg's bleeding.
Get your hands off me.
I'm medically trained, ma'am.
I don't care if you're a bloody surgeon. You're not touching me.
Okay, I'm sorry. It's my fault you fell off your bike. I'll get your bike fixed up. Free of charge. And I promise I'll never ever whistle again. Ever. Ever, ever. Cross my heart.
Shut up.
Nice bone.
It's true what they say about you Americans, ain't it?
What do they say about us Americans?
Overpaid, oversexed, and over here.
That's hard. We're not overpaid. I'm Sam. Sam Williams. You know, I play T-Bolt, the opposite of Stephen Warden. You ever been a Thunderbolt? I can take for a spin if you like. Or maybe you'd like to come to the dance with me on Saturday, the town hall in Lillington. We'll go for a spin on the dance floor, if you prefer. Can you jitterbug? I can show you all the moves. Or maybe you got a few moves of your own you can show me.
¿Qué está?
Thank you.
Also weiter gemacht, wo er aufgehört hat. Er lebt hier mit ihm. Antworte ihn.
Antworte ihn!
Perfekt! Was? Unbefleckte Empfänger?
She's not here, I know she's not. This is what you want. You have to be more careful, Craig. He's got all the lean, all the cold, he's all in there. Is there anything else inside?
No. Are you sure?
I wouldn't go in there. There's pussies everywhere. I know them earlier. The dog. We need to move quickly.
Where are you taking me?
Just outside Beauvais. It's about 50 kilometers from here.
Beauvais?
There's a plane dropping off the British agents. There will be space for you on the way back. You're going on.
This is my home now.
No,
You can't stay in France. It's not safe for you. You know too much. It's not safe for any of us if you remain here. You have to leave.
Christabel.
Christabel is strong. Believe me. She's made of the same stuff as her father. She will be fine.
She needs me.
Listen, my friend. It's too late. It will all be over by now. There's nothing you can do. It's war, Greg. War. It's not coming. Tout va bien?
Ouais.
Thank you.
Wir haben eine kleine Schwester hier, die gemeldet hat.
You were dead. You never wrote. Or anything. Not a word. How could you do that to me? My own son. I thought you were dead.
We've done it, Craig. Craig, we've done it. Craig! No, Craig! Where are you going? Thank you.
You are probably both wondering why I have chosen to tell you this story, and why I have spared you none of the unpleasant details. About 20 years ago, I made a shocking discovery. I was adopted as a young child. I came across the adoption papers purely by chance when both my parents were still alive. But they had brought me up with so much love that I could never bring myself to tell them that I had discovered the secret which they had decided to keep from me. But of course, curiosity is a very powerful thing. I wanted to find out more, and the more I found out, the more I needed to know. I was born in Abbeville in 1943 to a young French girl who had been captured by officers from the Sicherheitsdienst. Yes, of course, you realize now, don't you? Her name was Christabel. She died in labor in a basement of the town hall, which was being used to interrogate members of the French resistance. But I survived. And by a stroke of good fortune, I had blue eyes and blonde hair, a typical Aryan. So I was taken as part of the Nazi Ebensborn program. 6 months later, I was adopted by Wilhelm and Helga Gutenberg, your grandparents. Soon after Mama and Papa died, I decided to travel to England to find my birth father. By then, I already knew his name was Gregory Jackson. My journey took me all the way to Manor Farm. He was so there, farming the land, although he was frail and weak. Like Mama and Papa, he had carried the burden of his secrets throughout his life. He told me everything. His court-martial for desertion and the dark days he spent in prison for his brother's death. It all just poured out of him. He even took me into the barn to show me where he had entered Jake's life. I promised that I would go back and see him again, but as you know, my recent illness has been debilitating. I never made it back to England, so in a way, the story is incomplete. Gregory Jackson, your grandfather, grew old in the belief that brotherly love was just a fanciful notion which could never be a reality. There is a chance, a probability even, that he is now dead. But he may still be alive. Go and see him, William. Go and show him that he has two wonderful grandsons who love each other the way brothers should. To tell him that you both made me his son, the proudest man who ever lived. Do it for him, will you? And for me. Finish the story. Your loving father.